drainage systems, Himalayan river system and peninsular river system. Himalayan river system and peninsular river system. In Himalayan river system, we discussed regarding as an Indus river system, Ganga river system, and Brahmaputra river system. These three broader river system, which are basically covered the large and extensive area of north and northeastern parts of our country. North and northeastern parts of our country through their tributaries. For example, Indus River system includes as Ravi, Chenab, Jhelum, Bias, and Satluj. And Satluj. These five rivers are the main tributaries of Indus, which joined it in a Pakistan. In Pakistan, but in a parts of India, these five rivers, the land which generally lies in between of these five rivers is known as the Doabs, D-O-A-B, Doabs. Our Jalandhar is the part of Bist Doab. The term Bist, which evolved as a B-I from Bias, ST from Satluj. So the land in between of two river basins is known as the Doab, and Jalandhar, Pathankot, Hoshiarpur, they are lies in a Bist Doab. But when a land which is the highland which lies in between of two river basins is known as a water divide. That is known as the water divide, which we discuss in a Himalayan and peninsular river system. Second river system as Ganga, which we discuss, Ganga river system with their tributaries. The tributaries of Ganga river system are basically divided into the two parts as per their origin. Himalayan origin tributaries of Ganga, which includes Yamuna, Ghaggar, Gandak, Son, and Kosi. These are the Himalayan origin tributaries of Ganga River. And the peninsular origin tributaries of Ganga are Chambal, Ken, Betwa, Son, and Damodar. And Damodar are the peninsular origin rivers of Ganga River system. Then the third we discuss as a Brahmaputra river system, which generally has lies in the northeastern states of our country. Then we discuss regarding as peninsular river system, in which broadly the rivers are divided into two categories, westward flowing rivers and eastward flowing rivers. Westward flowing rivers are Narmada, Tapi, Mahi, Sabarmati, and Luni. These five are the westward flowing rivers. And eastward flowing rivers are Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, and Mahanadi. From these rivers, the Mettur Dam constructed on a Kaveri River. Nagarjuna Sagar Dam constructed on a Krishna River. Nagarjuna Sagar Dam constructed on Krishna River. And third, Hirakud Dam constructed on a Mahanadi River. Now, the turn of lakes. After the rivers, now the turn of lakes. Lakes. Lakes are what? Lakes are the depressions filled with water on the earth's surface and is entirely surrounded by land. I'm repeating again. A lake is a depression filled with water, depression filled with water on the surface of earth crust and surrounded by land. So any of a water body which is surrounded by the landmass is known as the lake. It is known as the lake. But on earth there are the large water bodies which are surrounded by the landmasses. These are also known as the sea, SEAS. They are also known as a sea. Example, Caspian Sea, CASPIAN, Caspian Sea is also an example of a lake because their size is a bigger water body which surrounded by the landmass is known as lake. And this Caspian Sea in European countries, it's bounded by a land-bounded water body. This is as the land-bounded water body. Understood? Is that clear, everybody? The meaning of a lakes. Now the next are the types of lakes. What are the different categories of lakes? Different categories of lakes. As per the existence, there are four categories of lakes. There are four categories of lakes. First, freshwater lakes. Second are the tectonic lakes. Lakes which are generally as a origin of tectonic movements are the tectonic lakes. Third are the saltwater lakes. And fourth are the man-made or artificial lake. Artificial or man-made lakes. I'm repeating again. Freshwater lakes. Second, tectonic lakes. Third, saltwater lakes. And fourth, artificial or man-made lakes. Let's start from the first. Freshwater lakes. Most of the freshwater lakes are in the Himalayan region. They are generally found in the Himalayan region. Most of the freshwater lakes are generally found in Himalayan region. They are of glacial origin. Such lakes are generally the glacial origin. Such freshwater lakes of Himalayas are generally the glacial origin. A glacier is one of the important agents of, it is the one of the important agents of dash forces. Lavlina, raise your hand. Titiksha from 9D, raise your hand. Ashpreet. Yes, Titiksha. Glaciers, they are,
yes, sir.
They are an important agents of dash. If you remember, in a second chapter, we learned the two kinds of the forces which are responsible for the carving landforms. So glaciers are the agents of dash forces which resulting the landforms on mountains. Titiksha, which type of forces which includes as glaciers as agents? Do you know the answer? Titiksha, do you know the answer?
Glacier origin.
In second chapter of geography, we learned the two forces, internal forces and external forces. So glaciers, which are work above the surface of the earth crust, these are the agents of external forces or exogenic forces. A glacier is the one of the important agents of erosion, E-R-O-S-I-O-N, erosion. The erosion processes of glaciers can create the irregular surfaces on glaciated lowlands. Pay attention everybody. Glacier is what? It is a frozen form of a river which slides along the slopes of mountains. As per the vertical slopes of mountains, such big size of glaciers, they are sliding in a downward. Glaciers generally slides in a downward. When the glacier slides along the slopes of mountains with their solid surface, big boulders slides along the slopes of mountains. And such boulders deposited by the glacier at their low-lying area, it may be as a valley, that land which is having as a flat surface. In such areas, glaciers, they left the materials, and glaciers, they generally as a melts. The ice, which when it has moved towards a downward, it starts to melt. And afterwards, it disappears. That water, which comes due to the melting of a glaciers, it goes towards the lakes and the rivers. Remember, radial pattern, centripetal pattern, in which are different streams coming from the different directions towards a common center. So in generally in a G&K, the glaciated areas, the snow-fed areas, from where the ice melts and the water streams, these are moving towards the center, through which the Wooler Lake came into existence. I'm repeating again, a glacier is one of the major important agents of erosion. Such erosional processes of glaciers can create as irregular surfaces. They can create irregular surfaces of glaciated lowland areas. Examples of freshwater lakes are Dull, Wooler, Dull, Wooler, W-U-L-A-R, Wooler, Bheemtal, Loktak, Barapani, Nainital, all these are the examples of freshwater lakes. All these are the freshwater lakes, natural lakes. These are the freshwater natural lakes. Clear? Because the artificial lakes are man-made lakes. They are also the freshwater lakes, but these are artificially constructed by humans for their needs. For their needs. Is that clear? Second category, second type of lakes are the tectonic lakes. Tectonic lakes. Yes, Ashmit, what is your query? Ashmit. Lake is a depression filled with water on the surface of earth crust and surrounded by land. And surrounded by landmass, or a large water body which surrounded by landmass is known as lake. Smaller water body surrounded by the landmass is a pond. P-O-N-D, pond. Larger water body which surrounded by the landmass is known as a lake. Clear? Second, tectonic lakes. Tectonic lakes. Tectonic lakes. Such lakes which originate due to folding and faulting processes. Folding and faulting, F-A-U-L-T-I-N-G, faulting processes, which create hollow structures, H-O-L-L-O-W, hollow structures on the surface of earth crust. Hollow structures on the surface of earth crust. Hollow structures on the surface of earth crust. These hollow structures may contain either salt or fresh water. It may either contain salt or fresh water. I'm repeating again. Tectonic lakes are such lakes which are the result of folding and faulting processes on the surfaces of earth crust, which creates hollow structures. Such hollow structures may contain either salt or fresh water. Example, Wooler. Wooler is only the one and only tectonic lake which has originated through the tectonic movements. The lake which originated due to the tectonic movements. So pay attention here. As you read in a second chapter, due to the compressional forces in between of Angara land and Gondwana land, Angara land which started to shift it towards a southward and Gondwana land in a northward, due to the compressional forces, the sediments present in a Tethysea, there were the folds were appear. And such folds, it was not as a single fold. There were the different number of folds were appear on a surfaces of such sediments which accumulated in a Tethysea through the rivers. Because when we are studying about the Himalayas, there are multiple ranges of the Himalayas. Lower Himalayas, Middle Himalayas, Upper Himalayas. They are the result due to the compressional forces occurred in between of Angara land and Gondwana land. So due to which the folds which occurred on a surfaces of a such sediments of a such sediments of a Tethysea in between of a two-folded structure, the lowland areas filled with water known as a tectonic lakes. They are the result of a folding processes. Understood? Folding processes. And a faulting process is transform movement. When one plate overlap by the other, due to which the block mountains came into existence. Block mountains, which we discuss in a second chapter. Block mountains, which are came into existence, their low-lying areas, their valleys filled with the water. And that water comes to the glaciated areas. So Vullar, which is located in a Kashmir valley, it is generally has a lies in a interior, the central parts of a mountain peaks. Every year, large quantities of water, it melts from a mountains and move towards their low-lying areas, through which the type of a lake came into existence is a Vullar, which is now known as a Vullar. That Vullar lake is used by the people for the shikaras, housing boats, shikaras, S-H-I-K-A-R-A-S. Shikaras are generally floating on a Vullar lake. This is an example of a tectonic lakes, such lakes which are the result of tectonic movements. In second chapter, we learned about the three tectonic movements, convergent movements in which two plates move towards each other, divergent movements in which two plates move away from each other, and transform movements in which the two plates slides in an opposite direction. It slides in an opposite direction or either in the same direction or overlap one upon the other. So under such circumstances, the folding and the faulting processes makes as a hollow structures on a surfaces of earth crust results the formation of tectonic lakes. Is that clear? Second type of a lake, tectonic lakes. Example, Vullar, W-U-L-A-R. Is that clear? Now the third, salt water leaks. Any lake that has no natural drainage outlet, any lake that has no natural drainage outlet. Outlet means the water is not drained out towards any other area. Water is stuck in a one area, one place, stuck. So any lake that has no natural drainage outlet, either as a surface stream or a subsurface flow, that particular water body flowing on a surface of the earth crust or either under the surface of earth crust, like as a Luni, which disappears in an Indo-Pak border. Luni River disappears and re-emerge in a run of Kutch. Same as certain number of lakes are there, which are generally flowing under the surfaces of earth crust. These salt water lakes, any lake that has no natural drainage outlet, either as a surface stream or subsurface flow, under the surfaces of earth crust, they will become saline, S-A-L-I-N-E. They will become saline. Example, Sambar. SAMBHAR, Sambhar Lake in Rajasthan. SAMBHAR. It's near the Sariska National Park. Sambhar Lake, SAMBHAR. Sambhar Lake in Rajasthan. Clear? There is one more subtype under the saltwater lakes which are known as lagoon. They are generally known as lagoon. This is also the example of a saltwater lake. Lagoon. Lagoon is a depression. Lagoon is generally a depression. Lagoon is a depression. Lagoon is a depression. Depression lies on the coast of country, lies on coastal plains. Lagoon is a depression, lies on coastal plains. Lagoon is a depression which lies on coastal plains, filled with saline water, filled with saline water during high tides. During high tides. During high tides. Pay attention. So in Odisha, there is as the small hollow depression has lies on a coast of the country. On the coast of the country in Odisha. In Odisha, that hollow structure, that depression is a result of the movements, internal movements, which cause as a depression. When the high tides comes, the water level of a sea and the ocean, it increases. Under such circumstances, it go beyond of their boundaries. Under such circumstances, ocean water, it goes beyond of their boundaries and filled the depressions which are lies nearer to the coast. Nearer to the coast is known as lagoon. This is known as lagoon. Example, Chilika Lake. C-H-I-L-I-K-E. Chilika Lake. I'm repeating again. Lagoons are the depressions. Lagoons are the depressions filled with saline water during high tides. During high tides. Clear? And tides are the diurnal process, as you read in your previous classes. Tides are the diurnal process. Daily tides are occur. Daily tides are occur due to the gravitational pull of sun and moon. Yes, Diya? Yes, Ashmit.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sir, आप sir ये जो lagoon है, ये sir saltwater lake की type है, ये क्या example है?
उसी के अंदर आ जाता है. It's also as known as the saltwater lakes. Lagoon is generally as a water body which has includes under the saltwater lakes. Saltwater lakes. Yes, Diya.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Mani.
Sir, I wanted to ask, sir, saltwater lakes जो हैं ये stagnant होने पे saline क्यों हो जाती हैं?
Again, repeat.
Sir, ये stagnant होने पे saline क्यों हो जाती हैं?
Stagnant होने पे saline इसलिए हो जाती है when the water accumulated in a one place for a longer duration. For a longer duration. And in desert areas where the evaporation processes are the more, water evaporates and saline content, it remains. That saline content, it exists due to from the soils. From soils where the water accumulated for a longer duration, longer duration, due to which the salinities naturally obtained from the soils. And in deserts where the due to high temperature water evaporates and the remaining water having as a more salt content. Clear, Diya? More salt content. So Chilika is an example of a lagoon, which is as the depression lies on a coastal plains filled with saline water, ocean water during the high tides. Now the last category, last type of a lakes are man-made or artificial lakes. Man-made or artificial lakes. In order to harness water or generate electricity or provide water for irrigation, dams are constructed. Dams are what? Dams are the barriers or the obstacles. Dams are the barriers or obstacles which are constructed across the river. Across the river, behind the walls of a dam where water collected is known as reservoirs. They are known as reservoirs. R-E-S-E-R, reservoirs. Reservoirs. I'm repeating again. Man-made or artificial lakes, in order to harness water for generation of electricity or water for irrigation, dams are constructed across the river. Behind the walls of dams, where water collected is known as reservoirs. They are known as reservoirs. Clear? Reservoirs. And such reservoirs are the artificial lake, man-made lake. Because here, in such reservoirs, water accumulated. Water is stagnantly present. In certain number of dams are there, where the water, it drain out through the canals for irrigation. Example, Govind Sagar Reservoir, G-O-B-I-N-D, Govind Sagar Reservoir, which built in Bhakra Nangal Dam on Satluj River. Another example, Govind Vallabh Pant Sagar, it is constructed in a Rihand Sagar Dam on Sone River is an example of a freshwater lake. You can write here as the Sukhna Lake of Chandigarh. That lake is used for the tourism. It's used for the tourism and the recreation purposes. This is also an example of an artificial lake, man-made lake. Artificially built that lake used for the recreational purposes, enjoyment, entertainment, boating purposes. not for the irrigation, not for the generation of electricity. Clear? So these were the different categories of lakes. Any questions? Yes, any questions in your side? Any questions? Next is as the role of a rivers in economy. Role of rivers in economy. What is the role of the rivers in economy? Pay attention, everybody. Pay attention, everybody. Dene chapter. This chapter now shifted towards the second term. Dene chapter, which now we are discussing, it's shifted towards the second term. So in a first term, there are total four chapters are there. Two chapters from geography. First chapter, India size, shape, location. And second chapter, physical divisions of India. Two chapters of geography and two chapters of economics. People as a resource, second chapter of economics, and the first chapter, the story of village Palampur. It constitutes under the September examinations. I'm repeating again, the two chapters, first two chapters of geography, first two chapters of economics, these are included under the September examination, the term one examinations. Clear? Understood, everybody? So it means our one chapter is remaining now. And this drainage chapter, it will be assessed in a second term. Drainage chapter assess in second term. Clear? That's what we will do on tomorrow. The role of a rivers in economy. We will start on tomorrow.